So then, well, we're going to have a question answer session. I'd just like to talk about treatment of emerging contaminants, biological treatment, and I'm just going to go through this very quickly. Basically, we see that biological treatment takes up a lot of the carcinogens, and it takes out a lot of the personal care products and pharmaceuticals that we have in wastewater. And basically, you know, there are a lot of things that control it, but probably SRT is one of the most important. The longer SRT, when we get nitrification, we see a high removal of many of these chemicals. Now, one of the reasons for removing NDMA, because it's a carcinogenic, and it's very interesting, there's a study going on now to see what the activated sludge plant could do to remove it at Los Angeles Sanitary District. And what they find is basically most of the precursors for NDMA is removed in the activated sludge process. But the problem there is they have not proper control of the scum removal, so they add polymers, and the polymers actually turned out to be the source of the NDMA in there. So yeah, this is one of the items we are thinking, very interested in removing. And there are so many others that studies have been done on this, and you can see, you know, for instance, also comparison between activated sludge and NBR, membrane bioreactors. Now, membrane bioreactors have the advantage of obviously the membrane, and also the longer SRT that's normally associated with it. And they run sometimes at mixed liquor solids, because of the membranes, they can run at much higher concentration of solids in the aeration basin. HRT for the membrane bioreactor is 7 to 10 hours, but they have a longer sludge age, whereas an activated sludge it could be as long as 22 hours. And that's always very important, but the SRT, as I said, can be raised, and that would help with the removal of these. And these are just some of the others. Many of these have been studied, and various removal rates are taking place in the activated sludge plant. Now, one of the problems, of course, is when you remove in the activated sludge plant, it may go to the digester, and is it removed in the digester? Many times not, so it gets to the sludge gets applied to land, and it washes back into the streams again. So we'll have to look at that more carefully. So SRT is a key operating parameter for degrading of the compounds. Results indicate that the SRT of 10 days is best for removal, similar to nitrification, denitrification. Each compound will have to be studied individually, and as you know, there are tens of thousands of them. So it's very difficult to say what it can do, but generally we see an improvement through the anaerobic, through the aerobic process. Here are some of the studies that have been done of what's removed and what's not removed. I'm not going through this, but then here is just another study that's been done on overall estrogenic activity, percentage removals. That's the oxidation ditch, normally high sludge age. So you can see in these long sludge age activated sludge plants, you see a fairly high rate of removal, but when you start getting to bio towers and other high rate processes like that, you see less of a removal. So the question is, for instance, in granular activated sludge, we know we have a very short retention time in there, but the studies have not been done on there to see what type of removals we'll get. So there's a, as I said, on emerging contaminants, there's a wide variety of opinions. Yeah, interesting. The increased levels of agricultural chemicals in the winter, higher soil sorption of ester, diol, and so forth here. And in summary, one must determine the treatment target, how much needs to be removed. And of course, that study goes hand in hand with whatever you do for water reclamation, how much would be removed by the reclamation process. And generally, as I said, that biological treatment of such ages over 10 days results in 90% removal of some specific compounds, and RO can result in 80% removal of nearly all organics. So it's a question of all the sequences of the processes and how they're removed. But it seems that having an activated sludge plant ahead is beneficial.